she said...
Your cat's in my garden.
I don't have a cat. I told her that. But she continued to suggest that I did.
Why don't you just hang up?
I don't know. I don't remember exactly why the conversation continued past that point, but I think we talked 10 minutes that first time. And then she called 2 days later and she said it.
Your cat's in my garden.
Couldn't hang up the phone. We talked 15, 20 minutes.
Come on, Will, all that time on the phone? More than one call? She didn't tell you her name?
No.
I find that hard to believe, Dwayne.
Look, I asked several times. All she ever said was...
What would you like my name to be?
After the first few calls, I figured it was some unspoken rule. I was afraid that... if I pressed it, she'd stop calling. Every time I picked up the phone and said hello, I prayed the voice on the other side would say...
Your cat is in my garden.
What would you two talk about?
Me. I told her things I've never told anyone.
So you'd stay on the phone for 20 minutes at a time for, what, therapy?
Okay, yeah, it got sexual.
It was phone sex, and she was good at it. She knew just what to say.
Must have been really hot. You must have wanted to meet her.
No, I'm a married man. I wouldn't cheat on my wife. In fact, my sex life with my wife was pretty much non-existent until she started calling.
Did you tell anybody?
I was embarrassed. I was obsessed with some mystery woman on the phone. If more than 3 days went by, I would panic, thinking she was never going to call again.
Do you know how she got your number, Dwayne?
No. She said...
You gave it to me. Don't you remember?
But I didn't. I'm pretty good at remembering things like that.
Do you ever eat at Majorca's?
All the time. What? She worked there?
The hostess.
I didn't notice her.